Hello friends, welcome to Study Spectra of Timmy Jain. Today we are going to study very important topic of class 10, simultaneous linear equation in two variables. When you rewrite this statement, it means we will take b2 on left hand side and c2 on right hand side. So it will be b1 by b2 is not equal to c1 by c2. Because on left hand side c2 is in multiplication, so on right hand side it will come in denominator or in division. In the same fashion, here b2 is in multiplication, so on left hand side it will come as division or in denominator. So now if you combine this statement and this statement, then you can easily say for having no solution the condition should be a1 by a2 is equal to b1 by b2, but this both should not be equal to c1 by c2. This is the condition for getting no solution. Okay, now start with this. This is zero. Okay, this is 0, so x into 0 is 0, it means left hand side is 0, and we are taking right hand side is also 0, we are taking right hand side as 0, so 0 on left hand side and right hand side is also 0, it means whatever the value will put at the place of x, suppose we are putting 1, so 1 into 0 equal to 1 into 0 is 0 and equal to 0, so it's getting satisfied. Suppose you are putting 2, the 2 into 0 is 0 on left hand side and right hand side is 0 itself, so it is getting satisfied. Now you are putting 100, 100 into 0 is 0, on right hand side it is 0, it means left hand side equal to RHS, so x equal to 100 is also satisfying this term. It means whatever the value will put on at the place of x and y, left hand side will be 0, and we are taking right hand side 0, it means we will get infinitely many solutions. So this is 0, it means b1 c2 equal to b2 c1. Okay, so b1 will take this term on left hand side, so b1 by b2 equal to c1 by c2. When we will combine this statement and this statement, then it will become a1 by a2 equal to b1 by b2 equal to c1 by c2, and this is the condition for infinitely many solutions. If it is not zero, you'll get infinitely many solutions. Now come to this condition. We have just discussed that whatever the value will put at the place of x and y, left hand side is 0, and we have assumed right hand side is 0, it means whatever the value will take at the place of x and y, LHS equal to RHS. Now understand this. So x into 0 equal to 0. Okay, so you will take any value of x will satisfy this condition. Okay, any value of x, the x you will take, the x into 0 is 0, it means LHS is 0, it means any value of x will satisfy this condition. It means for any value of x, LHS is equal to RHS. Okay, so we will get infinite solution in this case. So we will get infinite solution. Solution. Okay. Okay. Now combine both of these conditions. So here it is b1 c2 minus b2 c1 equal to 0. So b1 c2 is equal to, we'll take this term on right hand side, so it will be b2 c1. Okay. So we are interested to take this term on left hand side, and we want to combine b2 with b1. So it will be b1 by b2. In the same manner, we want to associate this c2 term with c1. So we'll take this term in the side where c1 is there. So c1 upon c2. So when we'll combine this and this condition, then we'll get a proper condition for infinitely many solutions. So a1 by a2 equal to b1 by b2 equal to c1 by c2. Okay. So for now, come to this y into 0 is 0, and again we are putting this is 0. So c1 c a2 minus c2 a1 is 0. So c1 a2 equal to c2 a1, so c1 by c2 equal to a1 by a2. So in this case also we will get the same condition. Okay. So we have just understood why the respective coefficient ratio gives you the information about the number of solutions. If a1 by a2 is not equal to b1 by b2, then you will get one solution. We have just understood. After that, we take this term as 0, and if it is 0, we get two type of condition, that this is not 0, this is not 0, and this is 0, this is 0. So this term is not 0, in this case we will get no solution, because x into 0, left hand side is 0, and we are taking right hand side not 0, means it cannot be equal at any value, for any value of x. So in this case, we will get no any value of x which will satisfy LHS and RHS. In third case, x into 0 is equal to right hand side is also 0, means whatever the value will put here, LHS will be 0 and RHS is also 0. So every value of x will satisfy this condition. And we have, in this condition there are two combined conditions. So here we have combined both of the conditions, this and this, and we got a1 by a2 equal to b1 by b2 and c1 by c2 for infinitely many solutions. Okay. So we are moving to another topic, very important topic for both point of view, equation reducible to linear equation. Now we'll understand this concept with the help of an example. Okay. So question is, you have to find the value of x and y such that 1 by 2x plus 1 by 3y equal to 2 and 1 by 3x plus 1 by 2y equal to 13 by 6. Now if you observe this equation, then you will find, just solve this first equation, just solve equation 1, you will find, what is LCM of 2x and 3y? It is 6xy. Okay. So 6xy divided by 2x is 3y, and 3y into 1 is 3y, plus 6xy divided by 3y, which is 2x, 2x into 1 is 2x equal to 2. So now do cross multiplication here. So this will be 3y plus 2x equal to 12xy. Okay. Now, if you were asked, this is a linear equation, then of course this is not a linear equation. Here, now come to why this is not a linear equation. Here, coefficient of variable has power 1. Here, it's okay. It's 1. It's okay. Now this has 1, power 1, it's okay. What is the power of xy term? It has 1 here and one here. So this term has power 2. It has index 2. So this is not a linear equation. This is not a linear equation. So in this case, we cannot apply the methods we have done earlier. But one very important point is here, you can make these equations, or you can convert these equation into linear equation. And how you convert these equations into linear equation? By substituting 1 by x equal to u and 1 by y equal to v. So now, for this type of question, where the given equations is not a linear equation, in that case you can make them a linear equation by substituting by applying your mind. Here you want to convert this equation as linear equation, so we'll substitute late 1 by x is u and 1 by y equal to v. So now rewrite these equations. So it will be 1 by 2 x is u, 1 by x is u, so we have placed 1 by 2 and the place of 1 at the place of 1 by x we have substituted u, plus 1 by 3 and at the place of 1 by y we have substituted v equal to 2. Now do the same thing for equation 2. So it is 1 by 3 u plus 1 by 2 v equal to 13 by 6. So now if someone asks you, these are a linear equation? Of course it is, because here variable u has one power and variable 1 v has one power. In the same way, here variable u has one power and v has power 1. Okay, so now we'll find first of all u and v, and we'll substitute here and we'll find x and y. Okay, so let's simplify this equation, the given equation. So this equation can be written as, we'll take LCM. LCM of 2 and 3 is 6. So 6 divided by 2 is 3. 3 into u is 3u plus 6 divided by 3 is 2. 2 into v is 2v equal to 2. So 3u plus 2v equal to 12. Suppose this is equation 1. Okay, now solve the second equation. You will take LCM is 6. Okay, so 6 divided by 3 is 2. 2 into u is 2u plus 6 divided by 2 is 3. 3 into v is 3v equal to 13 by 6. Here we are forming an equation in u and v, so we'll do cross multiplication, but we'll treat as 13 by 6. We'll not multiply 6 here because we have to keep constant on right hand side. Better, this term is on division on left hand side, so this 6 will go in right hand side with multiplication. So this will be 2u plus 3v equal to 13 by 6 into 6. So 6 and 6 will cancel out. So you are left with 2u plus 3v equal to 13. This is equation 2. You have got linear equation in u and v. So go for solving u and v by using any methods. So let's go for elimination method. So here we have equation. First equation is 3u plus 2v equal to 12. Okay, and second equation is 2u plus 3v equal to 13. Okay, so now we are going through elimination method. We'll solve this equation in ULV using elimination method. So first of all, you have to choose a variable. So here you can choose any variable U or V, because they have 2, 3, 3, 2. Both have same coefficient. So you can choose any variable. Suppose we have chosen V. We want to eliminate V. So we have to make the coefficient of V in both of the equation equal. Okay. So here it is 2, here it is 3. So to make it equal, we will take LCM of 2 and 3. So it is 6. So we will make coefficient of V in both of the equations 6. To get 6, we will multiply this equation by 3 and this equation by 2. Okay. So now 3 into 3 is U is 9U, plus 3 into 2V is 6V, and 12 into 3 is 36. Okay. Now 2 into 2U is 4U, plus 2 into 3V is 6V, and 13 into 2 is 26. Now we have chosen V to be eliminated. So here both have same sign, so you have to subtract both of the linear equation. So now now this is, suppose this is 3 and this is 4. So from 3 minus 4, because both have plus sign, means both have same sign, it means to cut V terms, we have to subtract both of the equation. So when we subtract both equation, we have to change the sign. So here it is plus, we have put minus. Here it is plus, we will minus. Here plus 26 is minus 26. Okay. So 9U minus 4U is 5U. And this term will cancel out. Okay. On right hand side, 36 minus 26 is 10. Therefore, U will be 10 by 5. 5 to the 10, so U is 2. Now, to find the value of V, we'll substitute this value of U in any one of the equation. We are putting the value of U in equation first. Now, putting the value of U in equation first. Okay, so first has 3u plus 2v equal to 12. So 3 at the place of u, we'll put 2. So 3 into 2 plus 2v equal to 12. 3 into 2 plus 2v equal to 12. So 3 into 2 is 6 plus 2v equal to 12. So we have to find the value of v. So we'll keep V on one side and constant term on right hand side. So 2V equal to 12 minus 6, which is 6. Therefore V will be 6 by 2, which is 3. So we have got value of U is 2. We have got value of U is 2 and V is 3. But our question is to find the value of X and Y. So we will revert back the value of U and V. So 1 by X is U. So 1 by X is U. So we will get 1 by X is equal to 2. Therefore 2X will go for cross multiplication. So 2X will be 1. Therefore X will be 1 by 2. So 1 by y equal to 3 by 1. So 3y equal to 1. We have done cross multiplication. Therefore, y will be 1 by 3. So value of x is 1 by 2 and value of y is 1 by 3. This is your final answer. This is your final answer. Okay. So in this type of question, Actually, these are not a linear equation. To make it linear equation, we have to substitute something so that it becomes linear equation. So our topic was equation reducible to linear equations. Okay, the equation which are not linear equation that can be reduced to linear equation by substituting something at the place of x and y. Okay, at the place of one, just as we have substituted 1 by x equal to u and 1 by y equal to v. We have to do this type of things to make it linear equations. There is another question. Question is 2 by root x plus 3 by root y equal to 2, and second equation is 4 by root x minus 9 by root y equal to minus 1. And first of all, we will observe whether these given equations are linear or not. So now, one thing, if 1 by some power a to a in denominator, when you take this whole terms in numerator, then sign of power will change. So this will become x minus a, okay? So when you take x in numerator, it will become root x means, root of x means x to the power 1 by 2. So 1 by root x, it means 1 by x to the power 1 by 2. When you take this whole term in the numerator, it will become x to the power minus half. Sign of index will change. Okay. So this means 2 into x to the power minus half plus 3 into y to the power minus half equal to 2. Here variable has some other constant, some other power or index other than 1, so it is not a linear equation. Not a linear equation. In the same way, the second equation is not a linear equation. Okay. So here we will substitute 1 by root x is equal to u and 1 by root y equal to v. Okay. So now, this first equation will get converted into 2 into 1 by root x, which is 2 into u plus 3 into 1 by root y is 3 into v is equal to 2. Okay? Now, the second equation, we can write the second equation in terms of variable u and v. 4 into 1 by root x, which is 4 into u, minus sign is there. So 9 into 1 by root y is 9 into v is equal to minus 1. Okay. So now both of these linear equations have been converted into a linear equation, but variable has been changed. Earlier it was in terms of x and y, now it has become linear equation in u and v. Okay, so first of all, we'll solve this linear equation for u and v. Now we'll revert back the value of u and v for getting x and y. Okay, so now suppose this is linear equation 1 and this is linear equation 2. Okay, now observe the variable here. Coefficient of u is 2, here coefficient of u is 4, and coefficient of v is 3 and coefficient of v is minus 9, but magnitude is 9. Okay. But here it is plus, it is minus, and we can easily observe that if we multiply equation 1 by 3, so it will become 9v and it is minus 9v. After that, we will add both these. After that, we will add and the v variable will be eliminated and we will get equation in u. Okay. You can also eliminate v, u, but you have to multiply equation 1 by 2, but after that you have to subtract both the equation because both have same sign. Okay, so better you will multiply 3 and add both of the equation and v will be eliminated. Okay, so multiply this by 3, so equation will change to 6u plus 3 into 3 is 9v equal to 2 into 3 is 6. Suppose this is equation 3. And second equation, 4u minus 9v equal to minus 1. This is equation 2. So to eliminate v, we have equated the coefficient of u and v. So we'll add 3 and 2. So this will, v will be eliminated or v will be cancelled out. So 6u plus 4u, that is 10u, and right hand side is 6 minus 1. 6 minus 1 is 5. Therefore, u will be 5 by 10, and 5 2s are 10, so it will be 1 by 2. Okay. Now, we have to find the value of v. We have just got the value of u. So we can substitute or put this value of u in any one of the equation. So now observe the equation. Here v has coefficient 3 and v has coefficient 9. So of course we'll go for coefficient 3. So we'll substitute the value of u in equation first. So substituting, value of u in equation 1. Okay. So 2 into 1 by 2. So 2 into 1 by 2 plus 3v equal to 2. So this 2 and this 2 is cancelled out, or this 2 will cut 2 by 1. So 1 into 1 is 1. So 1 plus 3v equal to 2. So 3 will be 2 minus 1, which is 1. Okay. Therefore, v will be 1 by 3. Okay. So we have got value of u is 1 by 2 and value of v is 1 by 3. Now we will revert back the value of u and v to get value of x and y. So here 1 by root x equal to u is 1 by 2. So we will do cross multiplication. So root x is equal to 2. So we have to get the value of x, so we will square both on the side. So squaring both on the side. So root x square equal to 2 square. When you square any numbers having a square root, then a square root will be vanished. So it will left, we will left with x, and this will be 4. So x is 4. Now go for finding y. So 1 by root y equal to v is 1 by 3. Again we will go for cross multiplication. So root y into 1 is root y, and 3 into 1 is 3. Okay. So we have to find value of y. Here we have got root under y is 3. So we'll square both sides. So it will be root y whole square equal to 3 square. Again we have square root and we have power 2, so square root will be vanished. So we are left with y, and 9 square, 3 square is 9. So we have got value of x is 4 and y is 9. So solution of these equation is x equal to 4 and y equal to 9.